Hi everyone, I just got back from my amazing vacation in Singapore, where I visited my beloved family and friends. Although I've lived in Los Angeles for 16 years, I was born and raised in Singapore, and I'll always be a true Singaporean girl at heart. So today, I'm delighted to show you the highlights from my trip to Singapore, namely on what I ate and did there. Singapore is famous for not only being a modern and cosmopolitan city, but also for being a food paradise. Now, a lot of people don't know that Singapore has some of the best vegetarian food in the world because Singaporean cuisine is quite meat-based. I was able to maintain a healthy and balanced lifestyle during my vacation. I ate all vegetarian food. Now, 80% of the food was super clean and then 20% indulgent. Eating healthy on vacation is possible. It's all in your own hands and what you choose to eat. Now, I never once felt deprived during this trip. Instead, I felt really liberated to feed myself with foods that nourished me yet tasted out of this world. So come along with me and check out my beautiful hometown and see why it makes me feel luminous. My first food stop is Sedeli. Sedeli is a popular local cafe serving healthy and wholesome dishes. I came here with my sister and my parents. I ordered the vegetable stacks, which consist of grilled mushroom, eggplant, and sweet potato cake in a pureed tomato sauce. It was healthy, light, fresh, and delectable, and I loved every bite of it. Second food stop is North South East West Vegetarian Restaurant, which serves a fusion of Singaporean and Western vegetarian delights. We ordered the stir-fried kai lan vegetables, kung pao monkey head mushrooms, stir-fried eggplant with pickled vegetables, fried rice, and vegetable curry. Let me say, it was impossible to stop eating. All the dishes were exceptional, and my favorites were the monkey head mushrooms and the fried rice. My next gastronomic stop is a durian stall in Chinatown. Durians are my favorite Southeast Asian fruit. It is dangerously spiky on the outside, but sweet, creamy, custard-like, and delectable on the inside. I ordered 4 durians and started pigging out like a glutton. Now, I didn't give a that people were staring at me. Who is this girl who is wolfing down such an obscene amount of durians? I was eating like an animal. I mean, but life is so short, so why not? Taken out of context, I can seem so out of place with the human race. But if you let me go. My next food stop is True Blue Cuisine, which is a restaurant serving local Peranakan food. Peranakan food is a mixture of Chinese and Malay cuisines and is a must-have for me whenever I visit Singapore. I love the gorgeous decor of the restaurant as it is so steeped in Peranakan heritage. We ordered the japchae, sweet potato leaves, Peranakan vegetable curry, and the pomelo salad. The flavors from all the dishes were bold, spicy, sweet, tangy, and savory. It is like being offered paradise in your mouth. I mean, what more can I ask for? Now, my journey takes me to Lingzhi Vegetarian Restaurant, where we had Chinese hot pot. There were loads of fresh vegetables to choose from their impressive buffet table. I was amazed at the variety of what was offered. I felt like a kid in a candy store. There's nothing more comforting than fresh vegetables tossed into a pot of hot, healthy, savory soup. I love how food always brings my family closer together. I wish time can stop and that I can freeze this moment forever.
Shades of motion blur my window pane. Shades of motion rush by again and again. Can a moment really last? Am I traveling too fast? Am I traveling too fast?
My next food destination is Real Food Grocer and Cafe. It is a cafe that offers organic, vegetarian, vegan, and gluten-free healthy dishes. I came here with my friend Fiona. We ordered the fruit rojak, the fried vermicelli, the classic green salad with sautéed mushrooms, and the chickpea and sweet potato cake. Here, I am tasting the chickpea and sweet potato cake. It is creamy, velvety, and drizzled with a tangy vegan mayonnaise. Absolutely lovely. The refreshing sweet and sour fruit rojak was to die for as well. Fiona really enjoyed the fried vermicelli, which is light yet well seasoned. Overall, it was a fantastic dish. So I spent that afternoon with Fiona, basking in good conversation in between bites of delicious food. It was such a beautiful day. My last food destination is Seven Sensations Vegetarian Restaurant, which specializes in modern, holistic, and healthy Asian and Western fusion cuisine. The menu was eclectic and showcased the creativity of the restaurant. I ordered the Vietnamese rolls and the baked portobello mushroom. I loved the Vietnamese rolls. They were crisp and fresh and also paired wonderfully with the sweet and sour dipping sauce. The baked portobello mushroom was spectacular. It was juicy and moist, stuffed with creamy tofu and chopped vegetables. I couldn't get enough of it. What a finale to my gastronomic journey. I'm happy to say that I took the time to smell the roses and I made each day count.